Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and while Apple announced WWDC 2022 would take place on June 6th, back at the beginning of April, they did not confirm when the keynote is or what the other schedule is. Today they have. So I wanted to go over where to watch WWDC, when it is, what to expect, maybe some apps, maybe some hardware surprises, and more. Now the first thing is, where to watch this? Well, you can typically watch it on YouTube or Apple.com. And if you go to the WWDC website, they've updated this saying Swiftly Approaching. So this sort of looks like the Power Rangers faces aligned in a row, and then you have red, yellow, green, blue, and sort of a purplish pink silhouette of a face against the black background. And it says Swiftly Approaching. Join developers worldwide from June 6th to 10th for an inspiring week of technology and community. Get a first look at Apple's latest platforms and technologies and sessions, explore the newest tools and tips, and connect with Apple experts in labs and digital lounges, all online and at no cost. So everyone can watch it. You can experience WWDC here, it says, or in the Apple Developer app. And then if we scroll down, you can see that it says Keynote and Platform State of the Union. And it says the Apple Worldwide Developer Conference kicks off with exciting reveals, inspiration, and new opportunities. Join the worldwide developer community for an in-depth look at the future of Apple platforms directly from Apple Park. Apple Keynote is June 6th at 10 a.m. Pacific time. So before, this is what we actually thought would happen, but they didn't confirm that until today. So June 6th at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern, and of course, you'll have to adjust that based on where you live. After that, they'll have the Platform State of the Union. This is more developer focused, talking about the overall platform itself, new tools for iOS 16, and more. And then, of course, if you're a developer, there's sessions, labs, digital lounges, challenges, Apple Design Awards, and forums. So all of those things will be available starting June 6th. And the best way to follow along is just to go to the developer app that's free, log in, and you can see all of the information there with the schedule and WWDC. So it gives you all of the same sort of information, and then you can find out more about sessions by going into here and then logging in and seeing all of the different information about it. So this will be updated as soon as different sessions are available. Now, today, Apple also introduced new Pride watch bands and watch faces. You can see it says Pride Threads. That's a new watch face, and you can switch the background on it. And you may have already gotten a notification for this if you have a watch. So that's something you can add to your watch if you want to do that. And then also in the store app, if we go to the store, in the store app, you can see that there's Threads of Pride and there's two new watch bands. So there's a sort of light mode and dark mode version of the Pride Edition Sport Loop and Pride Edition Nike Sport Loop. So the Nike Sport Loop is sort of a darker version and the Pride Edition Sport Loop is a lighter version. Those are both available right now for $49 on the Apple Store. So that's something you can order now, have shipped to you, or get it in the Apple Store very soon. So they introduce those as well. As far as what to expect, well, we expect iOS 16. I've talked about that many times before. However, it's possible they could rename it. Now that we no longer have iPod, so Apple discontinued the iPod and iPod Touch, we could see it renamed to iPhone OS. Years ago, it was called iPhone OS 1, iPhone OS 2, and they changed it to iOS. Now we could see that separated to iPhone OS. So that rumor is actually coming back around. Because we have iPhone OS, we could have iPadOS, because we already do, and then we have everything sort of separated. So we expect tvOS 16, watchOS 9, macOS 13, which is rumored to be called Mammoth, HomePod OS 16, or maybe they'll just call it AudioOS from now on. Now with iOS 16, we expect a major update and some changes to apps. That's what we know for now, but we haven't heard anything else about it, but not a major redesign, but probably app updates to make at least the icons more consistent across macOS, iPadOS, and iPhone OS or iOS, and hopefully some major app updates. That's what's rumored at this point. A lot of it seems to be a surprise, but it looks like we're going to get some of those changes. And as far as apps are concerned, Apple Music Classical is expected to be introduced. Some time ago, Apple acquired PrimePhonic and then never implemented it into Apple Music. That's a classical music service, and some of that has been in the code with iOS 15.5 betas. So we expect classical music to be coming very soon. In a separate app, though, is what it looks like. So instead of going into the music app, we would have something completely separate from this app, maybe something different than the music app, maybe a separate classical music or classical music section. Personally, I would love to see the Apple Music app get redesigned just to be a little bit more user-friendly. Also, we're expecting maybe some introductions of Pro apps for iPad. So on the iPad, we've had all of this power for a very long time with iPadOS, with the M1 that's inside this Mac or this iPad Pro rather, and also the latest iPad Air. We have an M1, but it's really being underutilized. So maybe a Final Cut Pro, a Logic Pro for this makes a lot of sense. And there's also rumors that you could put this in a dock and have it transform into a Mac. There's no reason whatsoever power-wise that you couldn't actually edit with Final Cut Pro on here. So I do expect some Pro apps. If not, I would be very surprised. In fact, we thought we'd see some of that last year. And then finally, when it comes to hardware, well, the hardware that's expected is maybe an update to MacBook. And we had the MacBook Pro updated to the M1 some time ago, but we're still waiting for maybe a revamp of this so we can have a redesign with this 13-inch or a similar design with upgraded internals. So the same sort of two Thunderbolt ports, along with a headphone jack on the other side. Not really much more is expected. However, some do say that we're going to get rid of the touch bar overall. So we could see something like that soon, but we may see small hardware revisions at WWDC. Along with that MacBook Pro, we could see the Mac Pro for the first time. Apple hinted that we would see it back in March at their event, and they said they'll leave that for a little bit later. It makes sense that we'll see the Mac Pro, at least see it. Whether or not it releases is hard to say, but we should at least see it for the first time, like they did years ago with the new Mac Pro, and they left it to come out later in the year. That makes a lot of sense. And then also one thing I really hope we see or think we will see is something that's been mentioned in the code for a very long time, and that's RealityOS. Many people have uncovered that RealityOS looks to be Apple's AR or VR headset operating system. It's been mentioned in the code here and there, and also is apparently heavily implemented within the code of iOS 16, so that it could work across platforms and work maybe with your phone. So having RealityOS, I would love to see a new operating system from Apple, and then an augmented reality headset or virtual reality headset that's long been rumored. Apple typically takes a very long time to come out with new hardware, sees what others do in the industry, such as MetaQuest or the Vive or other headsets, and then sort of finds the best way to do it for everyone else. So we could see our first look at that headset so developers can start developing apps for it. I really think we'll see something along those lines, as recently it's been rumored that they've shown it to their board members. So it looks like it's in the final stages and probably won't come out until later this year or early next, but usually with a new operating system, developers need time to actually implement that. And so those are the things I'm expecting at WWDC. Maybe there'll be a few more surprises, but I'm looking most forward to iPhone OS 16 or iOS 16. Let me know if you think they'll rename that in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.